Obviously, I'm old and conservative. If I somehow managed to find a website titled Lonely Girl 15, I certainly wouldn't visit it. And a site called Kate Modern sounds to me like that London gallery with the crack in the floor. With hits on these sites numbering the many, many millions, sadly, I'm on the outer.
Well, to make some sense of this 21st century high-tech Gen Y world of online entertainment, we're joined by web filmmaker Miles Beckett and Aussie-born cyberstar Tara Rushton. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Morning. How are you?
Good, thanks. Miles, what do you write on your business card? Do you write neuroscientist, doctor of medicine, plastic surgeon, online pioneer?
Well, it doesn't fit, so I can't really do that.
How do you describe yourself? Well, how do you describe what you do now?
I mean, I say that I'm a producer and I produce online interactive shows, and then people usually have a glazed look in their eyes, and I say it's like TV on the internet.
It's that easy.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I talk a little bit about the process of the filmmaking, the shows that we create. Sometimes, you know, there's about a 50-50 response when I say, oh, I created Lonely Girl 15. Half the time people are like, oh my God, that's amazing. Or again, they don't really know what it is, and I'll explain it.
Okay, let's talk about Lonely Girl 15. That was the first big foray for you.
Sure.
What was it, and what was it supposed to do?
I mean, really, it was about, you know, I quit medicine and I wanted to break into the entertainment business, but it's very hard to make it in Hollywood. And so I had a lot of ideas for storytelling and creating online videos. And I just saw YouTube and thought about how it was a new platform, a way to create new types of content, and came up with this storyline about this girl, Brie, you know, who lived in her bedroom and was homeschooled, and sort of this classic, almost a night story where she was rescued by this guy, Daniel. And so it was really about a traditional story, but then using a new medium and a new platform for telling that story.
And it was huge, wasn't it?
Yeah, no, it was crazy.
And it was helped along, was it helped along by the fact that people thought it was for real?
Yeah, I mean, there were sort of various stages of it where, you know, really the reason why people were watching it was because the videos were really entertaining. But once they kind of got hooked into it, people saw that there was this narrative emerging, and they thought, well, maybe somebody's actually writing this thing. And then there were clues that kept popping up, and there was definitely a lot of controversy about that.
Okay, let's fast forward now to Kate Modern.
Kate Modern, yeah.
How did you get involved in Kate Modern? Because you don't have an extensive acting background.
Yeah, basically, I ended up in London. I finished university, and I was modelling the past year and a half, kind of found myself in the States and Asia. And I was in Switzerland for a job, and I'd been in London for 5 weeks, and they said, look, we've got this audition for you, they need an Australian girl. They kind of said, you know, it's an online series, the producer of Lonely Girl 15. I was familiar with that and a big fan, so it was good for me because I wasn't going, what is this online kind of drama? Because I know people were quite hesitant about it at first.
Mm.
And then I ended up, probably because it's a new medium, it's a new form of entertainment, and it's definitely kind of like a bit of a generational thing. We're used to watching things on TV, and we're used to not being able to interact with characters, and now Kate Modern, my character, you can talk to Charlie and she will write back to you. You can ask her how her day was.
See, this is the fascinating thing, isn't it? Because now you are like a writer. You don't know where this story is going to go. If you're reacting to people who are asking you questions online, you don't know where the story is going to go, do you?
Well, and you're reacting in character, we should point out.
Well, the thing is, the difference is the writers are actually answering for Charlie. So I don't write back for Charlie, but I have my own pages, Tara, and so therefore people who want to talk to me about Charlie or about Tara being Charlie can write to me as well. There is a bit of a blurring of the reality and fiction thing, but when Kate Modern started, it was different from Lonely Girl 15 because people knew it was a show. Kate Modern was a show on the internet.
Right, right. So you just simply log on. If I want to, I just log on and then I can get involved. I'm instantly involved, am I?
Yeah, there's sort of multiple ways to interact with it. We really spent like the past year and a half with Lonely Girl 15 figuring out how do you create a narrative, a show online that works as a show that people can just kind of sit back and watch, but also is interactive. And it's hard, you know, we sort of tuned it to the audience, figured out how much interactivity do you want, how much defined plot. So we really do have a pretty consistent narrative each week, like a TV show. So, you know, if you watch across the week, you'll see multiple videos, you'll feel like there's a beginning, a middle, and an end.
Right.
Yeah.
And we script all that, you know, and we know where the storyline is going. But we plan for interactivity along the way. So we know that when people are watching on a Tuesday, Charlie's character will ask them to send messages to her. And then when we plan the next video, we know that there will be some response that the Charlie character will make back to the community.
Fantastic.
It's amazing, isn't it? Should we have a look at it?
Yes.
We've got a little snippet. If you're completely lost by what we're talking about, here is Kate Modden.
Hi, guys. Well, Kate and I just got back from our adventure with Weirdo and Sons.
I am the specialist.
Mission and a half, but I just want to tell you that we're both safe and sound. And Charlie's back in her own room with all her own stuff. And it feels amazing. Woo! Anyway, I've been asking Kate to use her special powers to hook me up on a certain date with someone special. I'm pretty sure you know who this is, though.
So how many cameras are involved there? Is there just the one webcam, or do you have cameras all over the place?
Yeah, I mean, we use a variety of cameras. So we use a mini DV HD camera for the webcam shots. We also use handheld cameras. In fact, Tara does some of the filming herself.
We do a lot of filming ourselves. It's almost quite guerrilla style, and that's again that whole reality fiction blurring, because we'll just be running around kind of filming each other and then also blogging straight to the camera. And that's why I think when people watch, they feel like they have a relationship with the characters. Because it is very, I mean, it's very personal. Blogging is.
Is it G-rated? Is there any nudity?
Oh, no.
No.
It's PG to PG-13 at most.
Oh, good.
We keep it pretty tame.
Is there censorship?
I mean, not really. It's the internet, right? So really we self-censor or self-regulate because there aren't really regulations online. But because we're the first people that are doing this, we're really concerned about making the medium as, you know, engaging and as open for as many people as possible.